Say, have you ever tried to recall how our life looked like before they got digital? Can anyone even remember how we got a taxi before Uber? Or booked a hotel before Airbnb? The digital revolution made endless things accessible to us and changed everyone's lives. Now, it also transforms volunteering to something much more accessible and enables all of us to change other people's life. Meet Tribu, a social nonprofit application that connects between people who want to help and those who need their help. With a simple and intuitive interface that enables everybody to easily find the areas in which they can contribute and reach those who need help and are just a screen touch away from us. And all that while being connected to the leading social networks. Is that great or what? Actually, Tribu makes volunteering not only accessible, but even more fun. Simply because when you volunteer together, you enjoy it much more, and it makes you come back for more. Tribu helps us do good to ourselves and others, because nothing makes you feel more meaningful than the great feeling of giving. We believe that together we can turn volunteering into a real movement, creating a culture of giving circles, and bring out the best that exists in every one of us. Or, like Gandhi said, the best way to find yourself is to lose yourself in the service of others. So, please join us and let's Tribu.
So, to say that Ron Zuckerman is a successful entrepreneur is the understatement of the year. We had to list all the companies that he started and took public, we'd be here all day. But Ron is also an incredibly generous guy, and I know that because he's been my friend for almost 60 years. And Michaela, if she wasn't so busy being a supermodel, she probably would have been a physician or a social worker or both. And she's an incredibly giving and nurturing person herself. So it's no surprise that the two of them wanted to be philanthropists but decided instead to contribute to become social entrepreneurs. We're going to hear about this incredible venture, the social venture called Tribu. So, Ron, tell us how your previous experience as a tech entrepreneur helped you create Tribu.
Okay, so we were actually involved in several philanthropic things we were doing before Tribu. And then when we started Tribu, I realized that if you want to be successful, you have to bring the discipline of the commercial world into this application. The world of application is a very, very difficult world. We all know that very, very, very few applications ever succeed. So we actually looked at Airbnb as an example, and we saw how Airbnb changed the world of hotels and rooms for rent, and we said, okay, we'll do the same with the volunteering world. And we are running it as if it is a commercial company. We're financing it ourselves, we got it myself, but we are really running it as a commercial company, and I'll explain more about it later.
Before we really get into start familiar with what Tribu is, can you give us a highlight of what is the initiative and what is your long-term vision for Tribu?
Okay, again, we believe that people volunteer, but they don't volunteer as much as they would have if it would be more accessible for them. Let's say I want to spend 1 hour a month with an elderly who's very lonely. Who do I call? Where do I go? It's very complicated. Same like you wanted to go and rent an apartment in somewhere in Japan, before Airbnb, where would you go? There's nowhere to go. So what we want to do here is get anyone that wants, that's the vision, and vision is anyone who needs something can get on the app and put a need on the app, and anyone who wants to contribute can go in, and in a very sophisticated and easy way, find a match, and then they can start volunteering. So that's that's the idea, and we think, or we believe we can change the world on that level. It's still yet to be proven, but early signs are very good.
In Michaela, is navigating this app easy, or is it going to require some training?
We try to make an app which would be very friendly and easy to the users of all ages. And also we have through the app there are tutorials. So if somebody gets in difficulty, there are tutorials that can demonstrate and help how to move on along the app.
Maybe you can show us how the app works.
Yes, so actually, so I will show you an example. We opened a hub for USC. So if I'm a student at USC, I just go into the app to Tribio. I download Tribio and tweet quickly. I download Tribio from the App Store. And then I sign in by my email or Facebook. And then there are two ways. Either I write down the university name and it pops up, or I can scroll down Tribio and see where my hub is. And here I arrive to UC University and I send a request to join it. And I see where I belong to, which group. There are many groups. It all depends on the organization, how they would like the students to enroll into which group. And once I get into Tribio to USC and I'm a freshman, for example, I see all the volunteering places that USC provides me that they can send me. In the little pictures, I can see my friends if they post in the same place that they can volunteer. And here are all the examples. This is, for example, from USC, they said. And there is another way that I can filter down the areas in which I would like to volunteer at, and the distances, if it's driving, biking, or walking, the days, the hours of the days, and also if I would like to do a one-time volunteering session, or I would like to do it more frequently. By the filter, this is what I received. These are the places I can volunteer in, and here I get, on each volunteering place, I get a description, and as you can see, I'm trying to do it as in other apps. I can either save it for later, I can share it with my friend, or I can contact. By contacting, there will be a pop-up coming up, either of the place that I can volunteer in order for me to contact them, or the manager of the volunteering at UC, for example, and if she wants to interview me before I would like to go to volunteer somewhere. For some places, they require, or for example, an interview. So it all depends on the organization. We really, really try to tailor the hub for each organization as they need it. So these are all workplaces that came up when they filtered down. And here I write down on the date that I would like to go, if it's weekly, the hours, for example, and now I received the volunteering, and now I get pop-ups. If I write down that I want to go Sunday and Monday from 12 to 2 o'clock, then I get a pop-up to remind me that I would go to volunteer. And it looks like that. I can say that I'm coming or I can't come, I can contact the place. And here are the time frames. It actually pops up on my calendar. It's synchronized with my Google calendar, so I won't miss my volunteering place and I remember to go. And here, this works for organizations. This is something that we built for organizations that the students must say the hours and somebody who is managing the volunteering want to see how many hours the students actually are going and if they are signing up. It's not a must, but we also have this an extra for an organization that wants to see how many hours the students are actually going. What we're trying to do in this app, we're trying to make it so the manager at an organization, a school, can see how many hours you go on. We can try to engage everybody, and also I will show you later soon, it works as a social app that you can post up pictures. If I'm a UC student, I can post up pictures from my volunteering place, videos, and I can have it connected. Facebook or Twitter, and of course at school at the end of the year we have wonderful pictures and videos of where our volunteer led. Again, as I said, it's really tailor-made for the school, so whatever the school needs, the school gives us the criteria what they need us to do, and we're trying to fulfill it. I'll go quickly. This is how it looks, for example, if I needed to sign in the hours and the times. So if you see a V and an X, it means that I said I went to the volunteering, but the manager of the volunteering place didn't sign up yet. They can sign up at the place, or they can sign up after a month or 2 months. And if I have 2 weeks, my manager signed up for me that I was there, and I signed up. Again, it's not a must. It's only for those places that want to see how many hours their students or the people who work at that company really volunteered in the okay, and this is an example of the social app that we did here. This is for kids. This we invented for little children because we didn't want kids at schools to have a shaming problem. So for them, we didn't let them write freely. We built positive words that they can play with about volunteering. So we try to avoid the shaming problem. And here we can put up, this is another example, here we can put up pictures of places we volunteered and enjoyed, and if, for example, we are a manager, the manager at UC, she, for example, can see how many hours each student volunteered the last week or the last month, where students prefer to volunteer, and have an eye on each one of them.
And that's it. Thank you, Michaela. Is this going to cost you?
I'm sorry, my English is not so good, and I'm a little bit excited.
For a good reason. Michelle, is it going to cost anything for the volunteers to use or the organizations to participate?
No, as Ron said, it's a philanthropic app, so it doesn't cost anything, and we're very excited about it.
So, you've implemented this in Israel. How long is it going?
So actually, we started in the program in Israel. We started in September, and we have about 5 or 6 organizations participating in it. You know, we started it in September, so we are basically on the air for the last 3 months, and we have over 100,000 of hours of volunteering signed up for the app. So it's a great success, and we're very, very happy about it.
So Ron, you know very well that there are thousands and thousands of apps loaded to the App Store every week. What do you think, why do you think this is different? Why do you think you're going to be successful?
So again, the key with an app, and you know, I have experience with that. I'm driving a taxi sometimes, and the guy looks at the mirror, looks back and he recognizes it, and he says, "Oh, you know, I have this great idea for an app." I said, "Yeah, what is it doing?" He says, "Well, it tells you if your dog is walking because he's happy or he's hungry." And I said, "Oh, well, I hope there's no traffic today." That happens to me all the time. And people sometimes come with great apps. And you know, the UI and the design is fantastic. And then you have to tell them, the key for an app is not how good the app is, it's the strategy for distribution. This is how you bring the users. It's very, very difficult. And that's why there are 50,000 apps going up on the App Store every month, and maybe one succeed a year. I mean, this is crazy when you think about it. And we thought a lot about how our penetration strategy is going to look like. And obviously, we took all the experience we have, and we were involved, as Hassim mentioned, as investors or executives. In many apps, like we invested in Uber in the early days, and Spotify, and we learned, and we're working now very closely with Snapchat. We're helping them with their future AR, augmented reality, they want to build into the app. And we built for ourselves a penetration or distribution strategy, and we start with schools. So, in Israel, for example, a student has to volunteers 60 hours a year to get his degree, or the end of the year to get his
to graduate,
exactly. So we started with schools, and as Michaela mentioned, it's going very, very well. We have now 5 schools that are completely, all the volunteering is done through the app. The kids are happy, they're sharing, some of them are doing more than 60 hours, which is crazy when you think about it. And our main goal is later to come to the elderly section of senior citizens and retirees, because we believe this is the most important segment for volunteering, and this is our strategy right now, and it's going very well.
So following that, how do you see seniors of Mark Friedman and David Crowder talk last night about the importance of engaging seniors? How do you see them fitting into the staff environment?
So again, as opposed to youngsters that are, volunteering will never be on top priority for them. I mean, they go to school, they have their first job, they have their boss, they have to find a wife, and they're very busy, or a husband, whatever. So it will never be high on their priority in terms of their life. For a senior citizen, we think if it's done right, it can be something very significant in their life. Because right now they look for something that will make them, will give them some feeling of that they're doing something. And if we do it right, if we know how to bring them into the app and into the volunteering, we believe that will be very, very significant. So our main target, after we run the app and we learn, we improve it with students, is to take it to the next step with senior citizens.
So I first heard about this app sitting on a boat overlooking the Mediterranean, and the minute I heard about it, I said, we've got to be part of this at a school. And Michaela, how soon do you think we can have a collaboration on?
Actually, we're ready. It all depends on the organization of UNC. When you guys want to be specific of to sit down together and to talk it, we can go on the air.
Yeah, Kate and her team, I think, are brainstorming about how to move this really rapidly forward. So Rob, tell me what else the UNC Learning Institute can do to advance this incredible concept.
Well, ideal for us, if we can do a pilot here, and a successful pilot can showcase it. We can be, Facebook started at Harvard, for that matter, and they really worked for a while in Harvard. And some of the shareholders were telling Mark Zuckerberg, let's move out, let's stop. And he says, no, let's first work there, see how it works, improve it, and then we'll move, to the Ivy Leagues and all the universities and the whole world. So we would love this to be our Harvard for that matter, and where we can pilot, improve the app, prepare it, and then take it out of the States.
I love that concept. So Ron, you have a dozen people who are working on this?
20.
how are you going to finance this when it becomes really big and you're going to need hundreds of people working?
Okay, when we go into scale, like any application, there's a lot of expenses that come with it. So far, we've been financing ourselves. Already, a few organizations wanted to kind of get on the train and be part of it, including helping us financially. But we also know from our previous experiences in the commercial world how to generate income from this app. You can imagine if there are tens of millions of people using it, there's a huge potential for getting revenues through the app, and you're going to get the revenues in the app and utilize these revenues to increase support some organizations that need support. So it's going to be a closed circle of money coming in and money going back into improving blockchain in this world.
So, what is your hope? What do you think Trigger is really going to achieve when it's a super successful Facebook like that?
Well, from first numbers, like Michaela mentioned, next year we already have an agreement with the Ministry of Education in Israel, so we're going to go into most probably all the high schools in Israel. That's over 1,000 high schools. We believe we're going to have close to 500,000 students using the app. That's an equivalent. If we can get 500,000 students and all in all about 1 million people in Israel using the app, that's an equivalent of the success of 100 million people worldwide. When you take the comparison of small Israel and big world, if we have 100 million people, let's say only volunteering once a month, that's 1.2 billion volunteering act, that's the vision for 5 years from now. Imagine 1.2 billion additional acts of volunteering in this world, how this world will be different. And from there, we'll double it every year. That's how we do it with apps. And I know it sounds like a little bit far-fetched, but you know, anyone familiar with Waze?
Yeah.
So when Waze, the founders of Waze came to us to fund them, and they told us, at the end of the day, every driver in the world will have Waze, and then we'll know whatever is happening anywhere on the streets all over the world. And I said, yeah, tell me about it. But they've done it, and there's no reason why we won't be able to do it. And that's our vision. A short story. A short story.
I know these people.
Yeah. just to demonstrate why we think this can be, that there's a real need for it. There's a lady here in California named Gail Cohen. She chairs one of the largest breast cancer and fights breast cancer organization. And she came to us and asked us to build an app for her. And we built the app for her. The app is very simple. She's been, unfortunately, a lot with families stricken by cancer. I take a family as an example. So there's a father, a mother, and three kids in the 20s, and God forbid the mother get breast cancer. One of the kids, let's say one of her daughters, starts managing the illness. And it's a full-time job, both physically and emotionally. It's huge. She has to run it through chemotherapy, and to take it to doctors, bring it to drive her here, and she's collapsing, the daughter's collapsing, taking care of her mother. And we built an app that specific daughter, beginning of the year, puts all the tasks for that week, what is needed to help the mother with her illness. And all the close family, friends, and neighbors take down the app, and they can choose to do something that week. And very soon, after a couple of weeks, all that daughter had to do was put the tasks on. And Michaela heard this story and said, well, if it works so well in this small environment, let's take it to the whole world. And we believe that if we bring the volunteering opportunity to you, and you can choose, and you can share it, and you can have fun with it, you will volunteer much more, and that's what we're trying to do.
Yeah, I know you're going to be able to do it. So thank you both. Thank you. Ready to go.